Yeehaw. All right. Howdy, 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 folks. I'm glad you're here. I'm here with Mr. Jason Brown of Love Food Truck Company. Thanks for joining us again, Jason. Love it. This is going to be a short show. It's too cold. But it is short anyway. Not a gob of questions on the Facebook page this week because we answered so many questions the other night. And
Monday.
So we're good. Hello to Amanda and Heather and Jose. Chef Jose was the winner of and I haven't had a chance to talk to him yet. But I know he's tried to call me. He's left me some messages and I haven't had a chance to talk to him. It's been hectic. And in this snowstorm thing, hence the lack of a hat. I still have it handy. Just ain't going to be wearing that. It doesn't keep the noggin warm. So, how are you braving the cold, Jason, up in Pennsylvania?
It was cold enough today. We didn't work. So I went and bought one more heater for inside the truck and turned that on and left the steam table at 120 and, you know, left the urn on for 150 and then left the pilots on the flat top to keep that, you know, semi-warm. But I lost a bunch of sodas overnight in this drink well. So, you know, I'm about to pull all those out and deal with broken bottles and exploded cans. I don't know if you guys know, but Diet Coke will be the first thing to freeze. It'll actually freeze before water. And when a can of Diet Coke explodes, it sounds like a 12-gauge shotgun shell. And it literally will take the can and just open it completely up. I mean, it's, wow. Hey, Matt, how you doing, bud? Yeah, yep. It's a noise that'll scare the crap out of you the first time you hear it.
Yeah, welcome, Matt and Manning. I'm here, the groovy alien. Jeanette and Matt, let's see, Danny Brown, Chris Kastner, thank y'all for being here. Let me tell you the vendor of the week, congratulations to Tucson Hot Dogs, which is really the Daily Dog Hot Dogs and Catering Company. And their Facebook page is Tucson Hot Dogs after Facebook, facebook.com/ Tucson Hot Dogs. The Daily Dog Hot Dogs and Catering. Congratulations. You can go to their page, give them some love, and check out their pictures. They've got a fantastic looking marinara dog that is beautiful. And then one that looks like it almost looks like a summer salad on a chili dog. It just looks beautiful. We've got two questions that are almost the same question that we're going to answer them both with one. And I'll start with it first is, do you have, it's too cold to vend outside. What other options are there so I can still make money? And the other question is, that's almost similar, is, can I offer anything from my commissary? I want to offer other menu items. So basically we can answer both these people's questions with the same thing. It is too cold to vend outside. Even Jason in an enclosed truck, it's just brutal. It's brutal.
When it gets below -10 for me, that's when the ski resort slows down, and then I just have to make the decision, is it worth burning propane, paying people, and I'll pull the plug. I cut bait, man. I don't hesitate, but I will work in the teens and stuff at the ski resort. But, you know, it means rotating sodas in and out from my drink well into the truck, so I have to have two I use milk crates, right. A double crate to hold my sodas stacked up, and it'll be two flavors, and we rotate them in and out throughout the day. So it's a bit of a pain in the butt, but you can do it. But if you're on a cart or something like that, Jenna had one blow up in her car. Oh, yeah, that'll scare the crap out of you. I'd say, you know, start doing some drop-off catering. If you haven't thought about doing catering, I would start now and start, you know, menu options are unlimited. I mean, we've talked about this on the show. We've done shows on Vendors United. You know, it's a great place to learn from other vendors. You know, join that. And there's no year-long contract. It's a month-to-month. But you should be doing catering.
And we have vendors doing simple catering where they're basically going by offices, giving samples of different soups. They go to their commissary, make their soups already, and then they have orders called in. And then they go and deliver these soups. Some of them are doing soups and sandwiches, but in the winter, soups are great. We have a vendor that's doing chili. That's all they deliver. They're delivering chili to offices and to, you know, different places that want, hey, we want, you know, 12 pints of chili or whatever it is. So
What I would suggest is coming up with a meal plan for the week. Get it out to them at least a week ahead of time, if not a week and a half ahead of time. And tell them that, you know, Monday's orders have to be in on Thursday the week before. Tuesday has to be Friday, you know, and give yourself some time. That way you've got time to shop for it, prep for it, pack and deliver.
Yeah, you can't really overspend that way. They can, you'll already know I've got to deliver 57 pints of chili and 31 pints or half pints of soup.
Yep. Now, the thing is, you know, another way to do it is you could find out the crypt keeper, as I call them, or the gatekeeper, the secretary at the front. You make friends with them. You get a phone number for them, and then you can text them the stuff, and they'll usually disseminate to the whole business. I mean, that's what I do with some of the pharmaceutical companies. You know, I have the girls at the front desk there. You make friends with them. I always give those girls free lunch, and they're the ones to send out my emails. So make friends with the gatekeeper. You get them that kind of list ahead of time. They disseminate it to the whole company, and bam, there's your drop-off catering in a nutshell. What's up, Mark Lawler? You're late. This will be deducted and reflected in your permit record, sir. Hey, Matt. Chef Jose won the card, sir. Matt Berry.
Yeah, and Chef Jose's here tonight listening, and we're going to have him on the show live sometime soon. And this mostly been my fault because of internet. I had to rent a little office off the mountain just to do the show.
If you didn't move so far up on a damn hill that takes 3 billy goats, 2 llamas, and 6 Sherpas to get there, you wouldn't have these internet issues.
I know. I was coming off of the mountain just a little bit ago. I was nervous because it's ice, you know, it's snow. It just yuck. Anyway, here's another one. Do you have other carts that you can build with the Build-A-Cart course? Yes, of course. Now, the Build-A-Cart course, what he's talking about is we have a course that you can build a cart. It's called buildacart.com. Just go to buildacart.com. It's got step-by-step videos and materials list to build a cash cow cart. Okay. But let's say you wanted to build something else. Jason's seen it. That fella in California built this mega cart all from it. We've had vendors do food trailers and trucks from it, because it's the basics. It's how to build the steam table yourself instead of buying a drop-in. Things you can do to save money, and so you can adapt it to fit your needs. That answers that one. Oh, I'm going to register my business name tomorrow. I just found out I can use it and reserved it, but should I register with And Catering in the name instead of just hot dogs?
Yes, you should.
Absolutely. In fact, if you had to choose one or the other, I'd choose catering before I'd choose hot dogs. If I wanted a shorter name.
If I'm right, I think I spoke to this guy the other night. I don't want to say his name because we don't have permission, but he has a kick-ass Sugar Skull logo. And I even suggested he has like a hot dog across the mouth, right? And I even suggested I take that out. I mean, I love the logo. As you know, I got Sugar Skulls tattooed on me. But I would suggest taking that hot dog out of the mouth, and then on his tent he had hot dogs, cold drinks, snacks. And I said, I put catering on there with a web address, and he said, wow, you know. And I just told him how we came about this with me, with love, and you know, oh, there's Kaylee. Yeah. And then I told him, I said, I just would rather see you make these changes now than lose traction and waste time later, because the menu will change, guys. You're gonna go. I don't care what anybody says. If you start with hot dogs, yes, there are guys. Even Michael Woods has adapted to catering. And they say you can't teach an old dog new tricks. So that's a lie. We've got Michael doing catering, and he's done tacos and a few other things. He was late tonight to the show, too, so his pay gets docked.
Yeah, he'll be
doing it. Mark's and Michael's pay for tonight.
Yep, so I'll mark it down. I got to tell my daughter hi. She's out in California taking her a little mini vacation. She called me tonight and said, Dad, it's like 73 here. What's your temperature there? And I said, you don't even want to know.
Yeah, negative
wind chills and stuff. Mm. But anyway, I love you, Kaylee. I think that's the first time she's ever come on the show or come in the room. Anyway, that's it. That's it. Unless you have a question. We're gonna call it quits. I appreciate it, and y'all don't risk yourself in the cold. Okay, yeah. figure out, take this time to, if you were in Vendors United, you'd already known to already have some catering stuff going. And when we say catering, like Jason just said, it is not this full blown catering thing. You don't have to start there. You don't ever have to even get there. It doesn't matter. You can start, and sometimes the better money and less headaches is on the smaller end of it, where you're dropping off stuff at offices and getting orders, pre-orders. There's a lot of that. Rob, that on my head is a beanie that I got in DC when I was, I took my son to the museum up there a few years ago, and it was cold then, and I got a, it wasn't this cold, but I got a beanie. It just says Washington, D.C. It makes me look all official, though, doesn't it?
I think it's actually the presidential crest, I believe.
I think it is, and I'm going to be upset if I said this wrong, because, you know, the one of the Secret Service agents for the president, he sent me his badge and all that stuff. He's a vendor, and he might have sent me this hat, and I may have got a different hat there. I don't remember for sure, I did.
Yeah, it's so cold down there in Georgia. Michael Woods had to get out of his flip flops and put on sneakers. He had frozen pipes down there in Georgia, which I thought hell froze over.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You know, we're going to send Michael. I saw some of those socks that cover most of your foot except for like your toes for flip flops. I was going to send him a set of those, but he said, nah, he's wearing boots and sneakers.
I heard from a vendor in Kissimmee, Florida today. And he said it was 30 degrees in Kissimmee.
That's crazy.
Mouse froze his ears off. I think I see a Keegan in the background.
Yeah, he's walking around there. That's the youngest lemonade brother. Yeah, Jose said it's 29 down there where he's at. So before we sign off, guys, remember, free training still available because, you know, Ben's hat's a little too tight still. I would suggest taking advantage of that before, you know, I convince him to start charging for it. So I've been doing it for free for quite a long time. He's the only guy offering free training. Okay. So you got to get your butt there, but the training is free. And if that's not good enough, 30 days or up to 30 days following your training, if you buy a cart or a trailer, he'll give you $300 towards your travel. All right. So, you know, now's the time to be thinking about these things. Even some of our guys that have been vending for half a season or a full season have taken advantage of this and come out and hung out with some of the street food pros. So talk about taking some serious time.
The Great American Hot Dog Stand, Mr. Mark Lawler here, he just booked somebody today. Somebody's coming to see him and just got booked today. So there's definitely some opportunities there for you to get professional training and to – It almost takes the edge off that nervousness, because once you see it done and you're there watching it in person, it's like, oh man, I can do this.
And we can. I mean, you're doing it. And in fact, I just got the other day, Mike Earl sent me a shell from a tank. It's like this big and it's got to be like this round. It's like a A1 M2 something tank shell, you know, as a thank you for having them out. And I got a UPS package, opened it up, and I was like, holy crap. But it's the, you know, the brass end of the shell. I mean, it's, I think I hear Pete, sounds like the little one got it.
Oh, my gosh.
There's a, you know.
Hold on, so Jay. I'm going to put you on solo so they can see that big. There you go.
So that is, that's the shell he sent me. It's brass. I don't know if you can see the end here. I'm still going to hold it up here. So it is a... M2A and M22 105 millimeter shell. So, you know, that was a little interesting to see coming in a UPS package.
Yeah. Jose, Chef Jose, well, I'm sorry, Mark just said that he booked three this week. And Jose, Chef Jose, who just won the cart Tuesday night. He is going to offer free training, and you're talking a cordon bleu trained chef going to be running a cart, has been already vending from a table, a pop-up table and a crock pot. So starting as simple as you can on a budget, he's done it. So can you imagine?
Guys, if you go back in some of the posts and see some of the plating and offerings that Chef Jose's put out, imagine going down there and training with him. you know, I mean, you got Chef, I have no clue here, and then you got Chef Cordon Bleu there. So, you know, and Heather put it up, Learn Hot Dogs, best day ever. You know, there's a link there. Also, Vendors United, guys, something you really should think about, especially through the winter. You know, if you're not out there vending, this is the time you can be going in and going back through the articles and reading things and learning and talking and seeing about new menu items, things like that. You can talk to Warren about a lemonade squisher, squasher, smasher thing, as Ben calls it, you know, and look at all these other menu options for catering. So, you know, think about it. Of course, Michael corrected me. G.I. Joe would know what it was.
Well,
it was still kind of crazy. I looked at that package and, you know, see the bottom of that thing looking at me.
We all should have the link there if you hadn't heard about this before somewhere, right? And maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, it's right over your eyes, basically, on my screen.
Yeah, it's right here.
Yeah, see, it's here when you're on my screen. It's right across your eyes.
Oh, right across.
Yeah, it's got Heather. And it says free training vendors.
Yeah.
.com/ best day ever.
Yep. Yep, that's it. Rob, if you will contact the service number, when you call the number, press service and ask them if what it would cost to ship to you. Typically, why we don't sell that flip top separately is because the shipping costs more than the flip top. So just ask, they'll be able to tell you what it's going to cost. They'll have to put it in the computer and tell you, oh, it's going to be 75 or it's going to be 275. To ship. So that way you can make a decision on that. That's why we don't list it. It's just a pain in the neck. People call and complain. You're going to charge me $350 to ship this to Washington? No, I'm not. The Postal Service is. Michael says he was field artillery. And Scott's in the house. Thank y'all for being here. I hope you have a wonderful week. Stay safe. Be good. Talk to y'all later.
See you guys.